The story of Jacob and Esau is like an exciting adventure in the Bible. These two brothers, who were twins, had many interesting and sometimes tricky moments together. Jacob was clever and often managed to come out on top, even though he was younger. It's amazing to think how he became a hero of faith, despite being a bit sneaky and self-centered at times. They were the grandsons of Abraham, of whom we learned in the previous episodes. The story of Esau and Jacob starts with their father, Isaac. Isaac was the son of Abraham, and he took care of the household after Abraham died. He was married to Rebekah, but even after many years of marriage, they remained childless. Isaac was 60 years old. He prayed to God for a child for a very long time, and soon Rebekah became pregnant. Rebekah gave birth to twins. The first boy had a reddish skin tone, and he had a lot of body hair. He looked very strong, too. They named him Esau, which meant hairy in Hebrew. The second boy came out of the womb holding Esau's heel. The child looked weak as well. So the parents named him Jacob, which meant to follow behind. Since Esau was the first child, he got the birthright from his father. This meant he would get a larger share of the property and belongings from his father. While Isaac loved Esau, Rebekah favored Jacob more. As they grew older, Esau became a skilled hunter, strong and with lots of body hair. Meanwhile, Jacob took on the responsibility of caring for the family's sheep. Jacob had a passion for reading and loved spending his free time immersed in many books. One day, after a long day of hunting, Esau returned home feeling famished. The smell of a delicious stew wafted through the air, and he followed it to the cooking pot where Jacob was stirring.
Jacob, I'm so hungry. Please, give me some of that stew you're cooking.
Of course, Esau. But first, you must give me something in return.
What do you want in return for a bowl of stew?
Your birthright. Promise me that you will give me the special blessing that comes with being the firstborn.
Oh, come on. What good is a birthright if I'm starving? Fine, take it. Just give me that stew.
And so, Esau gave away his birthright to Jacob in exchange for a simple bowl of stew. Little did he know that this decision would have significant consequences. As time passed, their father Isaac grew old and could barely see. Now Isaac recognized his sons by their voice and by their touch. Esau had a loud voice and had more body hair. Jacob had a lighter voice, and he had less hair on his hands. When Isaac realized that his death was fast approaching, he wanted to give his blessings to his firstborn, Esau. He called Esau to his side and told him,
Esau, my son, I am getting old, and I wish to bless you before I die. I want to eat your handmade delicious meal in my last time. I will bless you after eating it, so that God will also bless and support you.
Father, don't worry. I will go hunting and get a game right away.
Esau was excited and hurried off to hunt. But Rebekah, their mother, overheard this conversation. She wanted Jacob to get the blessings instead of Esau. She devised a plan to secure the blessings for Jacob, whom she believed deserved it more.
Listen, my son. I overheard your father talking to Esau. Now do exactly as I say. Go to the flock and bring me two choice young goats. I will prepare them in a way your father loves. Then you will take the delicious food to your father, and he will bless you instead of Esau.
Jacob was hesitant at first, fearing he might be caught deceiving his father. But he trusted his mother and agreed to her plan.
But mother, what if father finds out? Won't he curse me instead?
Don't worry, my dear. I will take the blame if anything goes wrong.
Following his mother's instructions, Jacob brought the goats, and Rebekah cooked them just as Isaac liked. Then she dressed Jacob in Esau's clothes and covered his hands and neck with goatskins to mimic Esau's hairy appearance.
I hope this works, Mother.
Have faith, my son. Take this food. Go now, and may the Lord be with you.
Jacob went into his father's tent, carrying the delicious meal.
Who are you?
I am Esau, your firstborn. I have brought your food you asked for.
How did you find it so quickly, my son?
The Lord led me to it, father.
Your voice sounds like Jacob. Come here to me. I will touch you once.
Jacob went to Isaac, and Isaac touched Jacob's hands. Jacob's body was covered with lambskin, and his body was smelling like Esau. Isaac began to believe that he is Esau.
I have prepared this delicious meal for you. Get up and eat.
Then Isaac got up and ate the food. He proceeded to bless him, unaware that it was Jacob and not Esau standing before him.
I will touch you once. May God give you the dew of heaven and the richness of earth, an abundance of grain and new wine. Nations will serve you, and peoples will bow down to you. You will be Lord over your brothers, and the descendants of your mother will bow down to you. May those who curse you be cursed, and those who blessed you be blessed.
As Jacob left his father's tent, carrying the blessing he had secured through deception, Esau returned from his hunt with the savory game he had prepared.
Father, I prepared the food you love. Please eat and bless me.
Who are you?
It's me, Esau, your firstborn. I've returned with the game just as you asked.
Isaac realized what had happened, and a deep sadness filled his heart. He knew he could not revoke the blessing he had given, for it was considered sacred and binding.
What happened, Father?
I have already blessed Jacob. He came to me pretending to be you.
When Isaac heard his father's words, he burst out with a loud and bitter cry and said to his father,
Bless me! Me too, my father!
I cannot. Jacob will stay blessed.
Esau was angry and then decided that he would kill Jacob. Esau said,
Jacob did wrong to me. First he took my birthright. And now he also fraudulently took away my rightful blessing. I will not leave him. I will kill him.
Rebekah went and told Jacob all that thing and told him to run away.
Flee at once to my brother Laban in Haran. Stay with him for a while until your brother's fury subsides. I will send word for you to come back when your brother is no longer angry.
Jacob was sad, but he knew he had to go far away. He walked for many days and nights, not knowing where he would end up. But Jacob believed that God was with him, just like God had been with his grandfather Abraham and his father Isaac. One night as Jacob slept under the stars, God appeared in his dream.
There is no need to fear, Jacob. I am the God of your ancestors, Abraham and Isaac. I will always protect you and support you, just like I did for them. I will give you this land and bring you back here one day.
When Jacob woke up, he was filled with joy and gratitude. He knew that God was watching over him on his journey, He took the stone he had placed under his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it. He called that place Bethel. Jacob reached Aram after several days of journey. There he went to live with Laban, who was Rebekah's brother. We will learn about this story in the next episode.